Shalom, sisters, brothers, on and off. And first off, I want to give all honor and glory to the Heavenly Father, Yahweh, and His Son, the Malach, the King, the High Priest, Yahweh Shai HaMashiach. Double honors to the elders and apostles and head bishops of Great Millstone, who do rule well in peace, and salutations to the Yah Shai Dawadah and the one-third. Now I want to get into this lesson. I write about the pure wickedness that is being stirred up out here in Babylon, and why the Lord, Yahweh Bashim, Yahweh Shai, is coming soon. See, He's letting all this build up, all the wickedness, all right, because this is a perverse place. We are living in Sodom in Egypt. We got the New World agenda going on, okay? Everything they're doing in the World Economic Committee, and we also got the common Babylonian demon walking around, all right? And they're possessed. We're dwelling amongst these people, right? And the Lord's going to drop their ass like flies, man. He's going to be justified, okay? The wicked are going to be put out, all right? Now, I want to get the book of Psalms, the 11th, because the Lord is judging these devils week by week on a serious tip. We're seeing everybody drop down, man. We're seeing people drop like flies. Athletes, regular people, you know, regular people, man, all of it, right? Why? Because they are exceedingly wicked, okay? This is Psalm 7:11. God judges the righteous, and God is angry with the wicked every day, man. Okay, now we got this video where these devils are actually kicking the Bible down the street, man. Okay, they're actually kicking the Bible like it's fun, like it's a soccer ball. Okay, we are living in these times. So what you read in prophecy about the wicked being destroyed, you are seeing why Yahweh is going to judge them. It's going to be a heavy dagger, man. Okay. I'm going to play a little bit of this. It's called Hate Crime.
Disrespectful. This is a hate crime. You realize you guys are committing a hate crime right now? You guys,
if this was a Quran, you would not have done that. You would not have done this if this was a Quran.
You're so fucking ridiculous.
What you did?
Give me my Bible back. That is a hate crime.
You don't have a permit.
It's all people that are anti.
Dude, she's not going to do that. She is not going to do that.
That right there is a hate crime. That is a hate crime. That is ungodly. That is wrong.
I can't believe these people. I can't believe that people would be this way. I can't believe they would do that.
Yeah. You know, got the brother even crying out there, man. Okay? And took the Bible and kicked it all through the parking lot and took it and threw it and put it in the porta potty. You see, this is why the Lord is going to bring down heavy fire, man. This is Ecclesiastes 12 and 14. For Yahweh shall bring every work into judgment and every secret thing, whether it be good or whether it be evil. You see, right? Everything He is going to bring into judgment, man. If He turn not, He will wet His sword. He have bent His bow and made it ready. He have also prepared for Him instruments of death. He ordaineth His arrows against the persecutors. All right. Behold, He travaileth the iniquity and have conceived mischief and brought forth falsehood. Right. And this is a form of falsehood. Disrespectful.
This is a hate crime.
Kicking the Bible like it's a soccer ball, man. And you know what this is. You see? We know what group this is out there. Just by the clothing, listening to them, and where they're at. Okay? These are witches and warlocks, man. Right? This is why the Lord said, why do the heathen rage? Alright? Heavy judgment is coming, man. Okay. Now, we know what group this is. Okay? We know what people this is, man. So you can see the spirits on them. Right? I'll play a little bit of this. Okay? Let's play a little bit of this.
Because you know that you're an enemy of God because you're in your sin. And that's what the problem comes down to. The Bible says he who loves the world is the enemy of God. You have enmity between you and God. Unless you accept Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior.
See, that's a man. Okay? Looking like a woman. Wanting to be a woman. Living like a woman, man. All right? This is off and this is wrong, but this is the spirit of Babylon. This is the spirit of Sodom and Egypt. And this is the spirit that's here now. It's heavy out here too, y'all. Right? We all see it. But this course must be played out. Right? To give Yahweh Ba'ashim Yahweh Shai that ultimate reason to send those chariots. Okay? Right? Because you are poking the big bear. All right? And that's Yahweh, man. Kicking the Bible down the street. Men wanting to be women, burning in their lust. Okay? Let's get that. Right? Because the Lord wrote about this. This is Romans 1 and 25. Who changed the truth of Yahweh into a lie and worship served the creature more than the creator, who is blessed forever. Amen. For this cause, God gave them up unto vile affections, for even their women did change their natural use into which is against their nature. And likewise, also the men, right? Also the men, likewise, what's it say? Burned in their lusts one toward another, men with men working which is unseemly, and receiving in themselves that recompense of their error, which was meet, right? So the Lord basically made them reprobates. Okay? They're supposed to be out there looking like this. Because they're destined for destruction. These are vessels fit for destruction. Right? They're reprobates. Verse 28. And even as they did not retain God in their knowledge. See, they didn't retain what this man is telling them. They're not retaining what the prophets are letting them know, that you're going to die by the sword, man. Okay? But what? Gave them over to a reprobate mind to do those things which are not convenient. You see? And this is not convenient. But this is the spirit out there. Right? Everything's against the Lord, man. Total defiance, total rebellion is in Babylon right now. Look at the street they're on. I wonder if that's a coincidence. Let's meet up on Church Street and do all types of wickedness and abominations.
Savior, you are God's enemy. And all God's enemies are rejected. They're cast out to outer darkness where they'll be weeping, wailing, and gnashing of teeth. You see how calm and peaceful and loving I am? You see how angry you are? You know why you're angry?
That's not his voice, but that's a demon that overcame his body. He's plagued with demons, right? And the rest of them are ready to go over there, man. This is all spiritual warfare that we in. Y'all can't forget that. This is spiritual warfare that you are in, man. This is not a game. And this is what the apostles is telling you, man. These damn demons can hop on you, man. Okay? Acts the 19th chapter speaks about this. Okay? Brothers going out, ain't built up, ain't got the right doctrine. Okay? And these demons can overtake you. All right? They ain't built up. Right? And these spirits, they know that you ain't built up. Right? And this is what the Spirit told. All right, those men that went out in the book of Acts, the 19th chapter, they weren't built up. That's why the Spirit said what, man? Okay, let's get it. Acts 19:15, and the evil spirit answered and said, Yahweh Shai I know, and Paul I know, but who are ye? Right? And the man in whom the evil spirit was leaped on them and overcame them and prevailed against them, so that they fled out of the house naked and wounded, man. You see? So these spirits can jump on you. These damn demons, man. See them? They over there ready. Right? This is why you got to have that spiritual hedge. Okay? Protect it. The angels of the Lord encampeth around his men. This nigga got his eyebrows waxed and the whole shit, man. Lipstick, makeup, blonde hair, getting popped. You see? We at the end days because we are speaking against these things. We are speaking righteousness. We calling this out.
What does racist mean? You guys need to go get dictionaries. I'm trying to save your life. If you die, you're going to go to hell.
You're not Jesus.
I'm trying to save your life.
There is no hell. Look at this devil. All right? You die and go to hell. No, you die and your spirit is going to go back up to Yahweh. Okay? And he's going to judge you. He's going to put torment on you. See? Right? They going to taste the lake of fire, man. Kolam la abanawa Yahweh shimei abashai. See, the circle of life goes to the Israelites. We have life. They're about death and persecution. They want to persecute the body. The bloodline, you know, they're a pro-death. They don't have, he ain't getting with no woman. You see? So he's pro-death. He ain't pro-life. You need a man and a woman and a man to have life, to give off life. These people are about death. They are against Yahweh and his son Yahweh Shai. So when America says the home of the brave, land of the free, one nation under God, they a goddamn lie. They protect these people. And if we say anything about them, our videos get cut, right? You're liable to lose your job, lose your things, lose your house, lose your possessions, things that you care for, because you spoke up against wickedness, right? That's why the Lord put us in these positions where we could call you out, because we just don't give a goddamn, okay? Right? We're standing up. For the Lord. The Lord says, who's going to stand up for me against the workers of iniquity? Well, these are the workers of iniquity.
You're not Jesus, black people. You're not.
I do.
I love my girlfriend. I even fucking
deal with it. You know what's sad? It's like all you care about is eating together. Like that's what your life consists of. You know how bad your life is? Your whole life revolves around sex. That's sad.
Gay lives matter.
See, we just read about this. We just read about this, man. Right? The evil spirit was leaped on them and overcame them. You see? See, this is real spit out here, man. Right? This brother out here, he should be with a camp. Right? Or be spiritually built up, man. You see? Knowing, having the faith that them angels are going to protect you. If he's out there speaking truth, right? Speaking of the mouth of the Holy Spirit, I don't think this is going to happen. You see? You got to have the right gospel. You have to have the right doctrine. And that's what Eve didn't have. Okay? Picking different leaves out of the garden, which was different doctrines and philosophies. And you will be overtaken. Right? Let's get back into this.
Your whole life. Look how angry LGBTQ members are. You know why you're angry? Because you're an enemy of God. You guys are all making my point. You know that you're God's enemy, so you're getting upset. Now, what you have to do is repent of your sins. If you repent of your sins, you won't be so upset. You know why these two lesbians are so upset? Because they know that they're in the wrong. They know that their relationship is unnatural. And she's talking about two lesbians can't have a baby, first of all. And so it's not only irrelevant, it's confusion. God is not the author of confusion.
I just want to know, like, what is wrong about, you know, the LGBTQ community? Personally, I grew up in a Catholic household.
That's not no demon right there, y'all. Look at this. Queer. This is a demon. This is Deuteronomy 32 and 41. If I wet my glittering sword and my hand take hold of judgment, I will render vengeance to my enemies. And I will reward them that hate me. Aren't they enemies of the Lord? The man just said that. He said, you are an enemy to God. Well, the Lord says what? He's going to render vengeance to his enemies. I will make my arrows drunk with blood, and my sword shall devour flesh, and that with the blood of the slain of the captives. Okay, we know who that is. From the beginning of revenges upon the enemy. Rejoice, O ye nations, with his people, for he will avenge the blood of his servants, and I will render vengeance to his adversaries. Right? The Lord's going to bring vengeance to the adversaries of Yahweh Bash and Yahweh Shai. They are consumed with evil and all out wicked. And this right here says a lot. All in her eyes, man.
From JK to grades 12, what's so wrong about being Catholic? No. You want to know?
I'm not a Catholic.
Sorry, I'm not Catholic. I mean LGBTQ.
Okay, the Bible says the Bible.
I'm not.
The Bible says it's an abomination. The Bible says wrong. Do you care about what God says?
Do you care?
No.
Do I care about what God says?
Do you care about what God says? Because these aren't my words. This is what God says.
Didn't they say not to it's a sin to lay with children, right?
But I'm not Catholic. We disagree with Catholics.
I'm talking about Christianity.
So Catholics aren't Christians, first of all.
I know that.
Okay, yeah.
I know that.
So what you're talking about is Catholics. Christians don't have sex with children.
No, I'm talking about in the Bible when they say, wasn't the Bible rewritten and translated thousands of times?
No.
Yes, it was.
So you know what translated means? Okay, because it was written in Hebrew, there's thousands and thousands of languages. So it tends to reason that God would have it transferred into Mandarin, into Cantonese, into Patois, into English, so everyone has a chance to be saved. So that's logical.
Thing is, God never said that it was a sin to be gay.
He does in 1 Corinthians 6:9, he says homosexuals will not inherit the kingdom of heaven.
Says where? Can I see?
Yeah, sure, absolutely. So, what's up? Hey, what's up, brother? God bless you. So right here it says that 1 Corinthians 6:9. Yeah. It says like, do you not know that the unrighteous will not inherit the kingdom of heaven? Do not be deceived. Neither you are. Neither fornicators, nor adulterers, nor adulterers, nor homosexuals, nor sodomites, nor thieves, nor the covets, nor drunkards, nor revilers, nor extortioners will inherit the kingdom of God. But also says, such were some of you. So some Christians used to be homosexuals. Some Christians used to be drunks. Hold on. Wait. Calm down. Use the quorum.
They're through. They're finished. And we just waiting for that sword to come, man. Right? For the Lord to let loose. And that's why he's going to send that fervent heat. Right, we'll close with this. This is the book of 2 Peter 3 and 10. But the day of the Lord will come as a thief in the night, in the which the heavens shall pass away with a great noise, and the elements shall melt with fervent heat, the earth also and the works that are therein shall be burned up. All right? All the works therein is going to be burnt up. And that's what we're waiting for. Give all honor and glory to Yahweh Bahashim, Yahweh Shai, Bahashim Rakakadash. I pray this lesson has been edifying. to the body and elect of Yahweh Hashem Avashai. This is the Brothers on the Moth. Shalom.